Now, there are really two components to the analyze stage: understanding where your application spends its time, and understanding what you want to do with the additional parallelism. So understanding hotspots is pretty straightforward. Often the programmer will have some intuition for this. They'll have some idea where the time is being spent in their code. But intuition can be wrong, and there's no substitute for data, so don't rely on intuition. So run your favorite profiler, whether that's gprof or vtune or the brilliantly named Very Sleepy Profiler, and look at how much time the various functions or lines of code take. You're going to get some output back that tells you how much time each function takes. So this function might take 10% of the time, this function might take 20% of the total time of the program. And in this case, the program is spending 50% of its time in this one function. So there's a clear hotspot here. Maybe your intuition would have told you that this is where the time is going. Often you do know that first hotspot, but sometimes you're surprised by that second and third hotspot. Sometimes they're not what you think. And this gives you a starting point on where to begin parallelizing the code, and an indication as well of how much speed up you can expect to do so. Let's drive that home with a quiz. So in this example that we've shown here, the question is, what is the maximum speed up possible that you could hope for if you parallelized this top function, the function which takes the most time? Okay, that's this one. And then I'll say, well, what if you parallelized the top three functions? So what if you parallelized all of these?